In this video, we are starting off with module 4. In module 4, we'll be studying about the shear strength of soil. So these are the topics in module 4. We'll be studying what is shear strength of soil, what are its practical applications, then what is Mohr Coulomb failure criterion, and how to use Mohr circle for finding the stresses, numerical problems based on that, the relationship between shear parameters and shear stresses, sorry, principal stresses. Then we'll be studying about some laboratory and field test in which we are finding stresses and the numerical problems based on that. Okay, so we'll first start with the shear strength of soil. See, when a load is applied on a body or soil, stresses will be developed. When we applied compressive load on the soil, due to this compressive load, shear stresses will be developed in the soil. Okay. Now, the maximum value of shear stress that a soil can take is known as the shear strength of soil. So, what is shear strength? It is the maximum value of shear stress the soil can take. Right. So, shear strength of soil is its maximum resistance to shear stress just before failure. And shear failure occurs when the shear stresses induced due to the applied compressive load exceeds the shear strength of soil. Okay. Now, see, this failure, shear failure, occurs by the relative movement of particles, not by the breaking of particles. That is, when failure occurs, the particles slide over one another. Each particle will not be breaking into different parts, but the particles will be sliding over one another. Like that, so many particles will be sliding over different particles and large mass of soil will be moving. That causes failure. Okay, so the failure is not by breaking of particles, but it is due to the relative movement of particles over one another. Now, what contributes to the shear strength of soil? There are different factors which contributes to the shear strength. First one is interlocking of particles. We know that in soil, the particles are of different shapes, maybe of different shapes. So, due to this irregularities in the shapes, there can be interlocking. Just like in the interlocking of the tiles. Okay, so just like that, there can be interlocking of particles, and this interlocking can contribute to the shear strength. Okay, the second parameter is the frictional resistance between the particles. We know that the failure occurs due to the relative movement of particles on one another. So, on the surface of the particles, there will be friction. So, this friction will contribute to the shear strength. The third factor is the cohesion. We know that cohesion is the force of attraction between the different particles. So, these are the factors which contributes to the shear strength. Out of these three, it is very difficult to measure the interlocking of particles effect. The effect of this factor is very difficult to determine. So, we'll be talking mostly about these two values, the frictional resistance between particles and cohesion. See, we have studied that frictional resistance can be specified in or can be explained in terms of angle of friction phi. In mechanics and all, we have studied the angle of friction. Okay, so we'll be using angle of friction phi and the cohesion C for expressing the shear strength. Okay, so that's all about shear strength of soil. Now, what are the practical applications of soil? In this figure, you can see a retaining wall. What do you mean by a retaining wall? A wall which contains or retains soil is known as retaining wall. We'll be constructing retaining wall for containing soils, okay, or retaining soils. So, in this figure, we see that this large mass of soil is sliding down. Shear failure is occurring about this plane, okay. So, this about this plane, shear failure is occurring means on this plane, the shear stress is more than the shear strength of the soil. Okay. So, in order to design retaining wall, we should get an idea, we should have an idea about the shear strength of soil. That is one application. Then, here in this figure, you can see an embankment and for embankment you have slopes. For the stability of the slopes also we need to know what is the shear strength of the soil. See here you can see this is the failure surface. Slopes will be failing like this. This entire soil will be moving. Okay. So for the stability of slopes, for designing slopes also we need to know the shear strength value of the soil. Then we have footings. For designing footings we need to know the bearing capacity of the soil. For finding bearing capacity of soil we need to know the shear strength of the soil. Okay, so if the shear stress developed in the soil is more than the shear strength of the soil, then the soil will fail. So these are the common practical applications, a few of practical applications of shear strength. Okay, now see, for defining shear strength we have different theories, and we in the module topics we have seen that we'll be studying about Moore Coulomb failure theory. Okay, so this Moore Coulomb failure theory is a combination of Coulomb theory and Moore theory. So first we'll study what is Coulomb theory, then we'll study what is Moore theory, and then we'll combine those two to form Moore Coulomb theory. Okay, so first we'll study what is Coulomb theory. According to Coulomb theory, the relationship between the normal stress and the shear stress is a linear function, or we can say that the shear strength is a linear function of normal stress on the plane. Okay, so in this graph, on this axis you have the normal stress, on this axis you have the shear stress. So the relationship, if you plot a graph between these two values, you'll be getting a straight line, and the equation of this line is given by tau f is equal to c plus sigma tan phi. Okay, so here tau f is the shear stress at failure. We know that shear stress at failure is nothing but the shear strength. So this term is denoted by s or tau f. S is the shear strength. Tau f is the shear stress at failure. Okay, so we'll be using these two notations for denoting shear strength. So the equation of this line is tau f is equal to c plus sigma tan phi. What is c? C is the cohesion. We have already seen what is cohesion. Cohesion is the force of attraction between particles, soil particles. What is sigma? Sigma is the normal stress. What is phi? Phi is the angle of internal friction. Okay, so this phi, practically this, if you form a heap of soil, a natural heap of soil, then this angle will be your angle of internal friction, phi. Hope it is clear from this figure. Here you have a free heap of soil, and this angle, if you are able to measure this angle will be the angle of internal friction. Okay, now this angle, as we have seen earlier, angle of internal friction and C directly contributes to the shear strength, and these parameters are known as shear parameters. C and phi are known as the shear parameters. Okay, now let me redraw this graph. Here, see how to obtain this equation. Tau f is equal to C plus sigma tan phi. See, at this point I have drawn a straight line. So what will be this angle? Here we know that this angle is phi. So what will be this angle? It will be phi itself. Now, this length is tau f. Okay, so I am cutting this tau f into two halves. So what will be this length? We know that this length is C. So this length is nothing but C. What is the remaining portion? Consider this small triangle. Here this base will be sigma and this angle is phi. So this side will be sigma tan phi. The base is sigma, angle is phi. So this length will be sigma tan phi. So what will be tau f? Tau f is equal to C plus sigma tan phi. That is how you get this equation. Okay, so that is Coulomb theory. The main point to be noted is that you will get a linear variation between tau and sigma. The graph is a straight line, or the failure envelope is a straight line. Okay, Now, let me have this graph over here. We have seen that C, coefficient C and angle of internal friction phi contributes to the shear strength. So, this type of soil, the soils for which you have this type of curve is known as C phi soil. Okay, C phi soil. We can say that coefficient C and angle of friction phi contributes to the shear strength of the soil. So, this is a C phi soil. And silty soil is an example of C phi soil. Now, there are soils in which the C value is 0. So, will be the starting of the curve. If the C value is 0, the starting of the curve will be at the origin, like this. So, here you have only phi value, C value 0. So, this type of soil is known as phi soil. Or, here, is there any cohesion? No. So, this type of soil is also known as cohesionless soil or frictional soil. Okay. Pure sand is an example of phi soil. Now, we have the third type of soil in which phi value will be 0. What is phi? Phi is this angle. If this angle is 0, what will be the shape of the line? It will be a straight line. So, this is the curve. Okay. Here, phi is 0. We have only cohesion. So, this soil, this type of soil is known as C soil. Also, it is known as cohesive soil or frictionless soil. Frictionless soil. Okay. Pure clay is an example of C soil. Right. Now, we will move on to Mohr theory. We have studied what is Coulomb theory. According to Coulomb theory, the main point is that the relationship between tau and sigma is a straight line and you know the equation. Okay. Now, in Mohr theory, Mohr stated that failure is occurring by a critical combination of normal and shear stress. When you have a particular critical value for normal and shear stress, failure occurs. And the relation, and we, he stated that the function, the tau f value is a unique function of sigma. Okay, normal stress sigma. Okay, and if you draw a curve based on this equation, you will be getting a curve like this, and this curve is known as Mohr failure envelope. Okay, so the curve defined by this equation is known as Mohr failure envelope. The important point to be noted is that this line is not a straight line, it is a curve. Here you can see a small curve, isn't it? So Mohr failure envelope is a curve line. It's not a straight line, it is a curve. Okay, and second point to be noted is that you can see a Mohr circle over here, isn't it? So this failure plane, Mohr failure plane, is tangential to the Mohr circle. That is the next point to be noted. The curved failure envelope is tangential to the Mohr circle. Okay, so here this is the point to be noted. This is tangential to the Mohr circle. Now, we are going to study Mohr Coulomb theory. Mohr Coulomb theory, we are combining Mohr theory and Coulomb theory. We have studied in Coulomb theory that the line or the variation is linear, and in Coulomb, in Mohr theory, we have studied that the line is tangential to the Mohr circle. So, we combine those two points. Okay, combining Coulomb linear equation with the tangency between Mohr circle and the failure envelope at the time of failure. Okay, so the curved Mohr envelope is replaced by a straight line. This straight line, you can see the straight line, isn't it? Here, this is not curved, this is a straight line. This straight line is known as Mohr Coulomb failure envelope. Okay, so the straight line tangential to the Mohr circle at the failure is known as Mohr Coulomb failure envelope. Okay, now what is the Mohr Coulomb failure criterion? How to know whether failure occurs or not based on this line? Okay, so this criteria can be written as the equation of this line. So, equation of the straight line is taken from the Coulomb's theory. The same equation is taken. Okay, so the Mohr Coulomb failure criterion can be written as the equation for the line, which represents the failure envelope. So, this straight line represents the failure envelope, and the equation of the failure envelope is same as that of the Coulomb's equation. And here also tau f is the shear strength, sigma is the normal stress, phi is the angle of internal friction, and c is the cohesion. Phi and c are known as the shear parameters. Okay, now in this figure you can see point A, isn't it? This point A will be stable because it is much below the failure envelope. Or if you have a soil in which the Mohr circle is below, is not touching the failure envelope, then that soil will be stable. Okay, if the Mohr circle of a soil is touching the failure envelope, then that soil will fail. See, here we can see a Mohr circle. The soil corresponding to this Mohr circle will fail because this Mohr circle touches the failure envelope. Okay, so that is point B. At point B you can have failure. Point A is stable. Now you can see point C. Point C is not possible because you will not get a point above the failure plane because the soil has already failed. So you will never get a point above the failure plane. So this is the failure criterion based on Mohr-Coulomb theory. Okay, so this is the graphical way of explaining things. If the point is below, it is stable. If it is on the failure plane, it fails. You will never get a point above the failure plane. Okay, yeah, here this delta sigma is the additional load. Initially delta sigma was not there, this violet thing was not there. Initially only ground level was there. So at that point the stresses were sigma v and sigma h. Based on sigma v and sigma h, we can draw a Mohr circle and you'll be getting this Mohr circle. Okay, now what I do is I place an extra load, violet extra load is placed, and due to that sigma v becomes sigma v plus delta sigma. So you'll be getting a bigger Mohr circle. This violet Mohr circle is obtained. Okay, again the soil is safe because this is the failure plane. So the Mohr circle is below the failure plane, so the soil will be safe. Now if I again add the load, what will happen? The Mohr circle will become bigger and bigger, and at one point it will touch the failure plane. At that point the soil will fail. Okay, so this is how you explain the failure criteria based on Mohr-Coulomb theory. So here I have explained using graphical method, isn't it? So this failure criteria can be explained using equations, using analytical method also. So this is the equation. Failure criteria can be written in terms of principal stresses and shear parameters. So in this equation, sigma 1 and sigma 3 are the principal stresses and C and phi are the shear parameters. So this is the relationship between shear parameters and principal stresses. So you can do problems based on this equation also. So when problems are asked, we can solve it using the graphical method by drawing Mohr circles. You can solve the problem, as well as using this equation also you can solve the problems. Okay, we'll continue in the next video.